the first and the last. He that dwelleth in the heaven, and the earth is your footstool. The great provider, our shield and our buckler, our defender, our healer, our restorer, our chief advocate. We are here again tonight. Somebody here is broken. Someone in the middle confused. Someone is disturbed. Someone here cannot understand God. While their life is shaking and rocking. They have come, Lord, to drink from your river. They have come, Lord, to drink tonight. Some came for a word. He said, Lord, just a word for you will settle my life. So I confused. I want you to speak tonight into that situation. Father, how long, someone is asking, will I continue like this? From 2016 to 2017, I'm about to end the year again the same old level. Father, speak and bring it to an end. Thank you, Jesus. Let your presence saturate this place. Let your glory overshadow us. May we not leave this place the same. Do something new in our lives. Thank you, Father. We know when we call, you answer. When we knock, you open. When we seek, we find. Tonight is your night. Speak to us. Thank you, Father. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. And let the people that love the Lord shout amen. Remain standing. We are going to the Bible. Daniel chapter 6, 16 to 17. It's right on the screen there. Then the king commanded and they brought Daniel and cast him into the den of lions. Now the king spake and said unto Daniel, that God whom thou servest continually, he will deliver thee. The same man that placed it inside, the same man said, let the God set you free. Verse 17, the last. And a stone was brought and lay upon the mouth of the den, and the king sealed it with his own signet and with the signet of his lords, that the purpose might not be changed concerning Daniel. Someone say, it got to change. Someone scream, it got to change. Someone shout, it got to change. That the purpose might not be changed concerning Daniel. That the purpose of placing behind the stone may not be changed. I want to minister tonight on what I title. Who placed you behind that stone? Who placed you behind that stone? Can you walk the three persons quickly? Ask that question and let's see the answer. Who bless you behind that stone? Who bless you behind that stone? The stone of frustration. Who bless you there? Who bless you there? Remain standing. Genesis chapter 29, verse 3. Genesis chapter 29. Verses 3. Let's get it quickly on the screen. Genesis chapter 29, verses 3. I'm waiting. Place you behind that stone. We'll read from about quickly while you're trying to bring on the screen. When all the flocks were gathered there, the shepherds will roll the stones away from the well's mouth and water the sheep. Then they will return the stone to its place over the mouth of the well. Look at that scripture again. When all the flocks were gathered there, the shepherds will roll the stone away from the well's mouth and water the sheep. Then they will return the stone to a place over the mouth of the well. Something there. They remove the stone and then they drew water. And then they cover it for the next person not to draw. Listen now. They cover it again for the next person coming not to draw. After you have been blessed, they say nobody else in the family will be blessed again. The place is still there. Who bless you behind that stone? Listen. The stone is to block you from going forward. The stone is to block you from going forward. When you are placed behind the stone, you cannot see your way out. When you are placed behind the stone, you can't find your way out. You will be torn in one place every year. One place every year. In the same place every year. That's all it is. How do you know that you are behind the stone? I have a few points here. Number one. When your labor has no results. How do you know that you are behind the stone? Sign number one. When your labor has no results, you are behind the stone. Laboring without profit. Jumping and you can't understand your income. You are behind the stone. Number two. When your age is not matching your substance. When your age is not matching your substance, you are behind the stone. You are 70 years old, but have nothing to show based upon your age. Your age is there, but no results to match your age. People don't respect you based upon the gray hair. They respect the results that run the gray hair. Take note of that. People don't value the gray hair. They value the results that follow the gray hair.
Yes,
sir. It is not age, it's results. Yeah. You know my age. Like those days. You know my age? Those days. When the elders will stand and talk with nothing to show, you stand and talk and people bow. Now, it's resource. When you talk, you should talk cash. This person, what we need, it's not leaking pocket and talk. It's not the first son, Reuben. It's Joseph talking. It's not Reuben. Is Joseph giving shelter to Ruby in Egypt?
Yes, sir.
These are my brethren. Please allow them to stay in Goshen. He was not the first, but result was speaking. He stood before the king to talk. Ruby was behind the bar. And Joseph was speaking. He was not the third, he was not the fourth, he was not the fifth, he was the second to the last, but results making the first.
Yes, sir. Bless you, sir.
Is what you carry that make your family to be recognized. If one man in the family that can speak with substance, people respect the family. So when your edge is not matching your substance, then you are behind the stone. Number three, when the one you trust, if the same person kill you. Darius and Daniel, look at the relationship. They were connected. If the people conspire against Daniel, to frustrate him, and the decree was made. Now King Darius, you understand everything that this man is your best friend. Why would you sign it? Read the Bible. He was the one that signed it with his signet. He sealed it up. Then he said, the God that you trust, let him save you. Your best friend. If your friends can betray you, you are behind the stone. Behind the stone. Bible says that Daniel worshiped God three times a day. And the people knew they couldn't go nowhere else but that place of worship. It will arrest Daniel, it will deal with him. It's worshiping his God. They collected him to close the matter. They cut the story short. They collected Daniel worshiping God, not going against God, but worshiping God. He was worshiping God when they arrested him. God couldn't stop him there. They arrested Daniel. They took Daniel and threw it into the lion's den. And they took the stone and sealed it up. He was behind the stone. He was living, but nobody was seeing him. Daniel was existing. He was behind the stone. He was alive, but he was covered. I said he was alive, but he was covered. You can be living, but no one seeing you. When you are behind the stone, what's supposed to take 1 year will take 10 years. What you're supposed to achieve in 1 year will take 10 years because you're behind the stone. When you are behind the stone, you will use more human strength. Human strength, the human strength will be more. You will struggle more. When you are behind the stone, helpers will not see you. When you are behind the stone, you look ugly, but you are beautiful. When you are behind the stone, you walk hard, but you can't find anything at the end of the week or the end of the month. When you are behind the stone, you can't pay your bills, but you are working. When you're behind the stone, your friends mock at you. And they say you are lazy, but you're not lazy. Right. Behind the stone. Who bless you behind that stone? Yeah. Why is my life like this? Or that you know your talent, your gift, and your degree. Yes, they have nothing to show. Who did this to you? Who make you to be like this in the United States of America? You still struggle like that in Africa. What made you to be like this? You are crying back home in Africa. And you came here and you stay crying. What did this to you? Oh my God. They collected Daniel, a man called by God, anointed, representing God in the streets. He was arrested and placed into the lion's den. They locked him with a stone. He was behind the stone. He couldn't see daylight. That many of you are walking on the street of Philadelphia, you think people are looking at you, but nobody looking at you. Nobody. That's why nothing is happening. You've gone 2-3 years. You got a mighty stone have blocked your way. They hide you behind the stone. Every time you try to get out of the stone, block you. People come to assist you and get discouraged. People come into your life, they frustrate you and walk out because you're behind the stone. And you shout, and then you are free today. Break you from that place. Every demonic stone that hide your life. Every pattern stone that cover your future. Every family stone that hide your face. Let that stone scatter. Let that stone scatter. Let that stone scatter. Every stone they place you behind. They say you will not be recognized. You will not have results. You will not make it to the next level. Your effort will be useless. Your beauty will be frustrated. Today by fire, may God release you from behind that stone. The stone that blocked your father will not stop you. That stone that hides your mother will not hide you. The stone that hides your siblings will not hide you. Whosoever placed you in the grave up, not leaning on your hide, not leaning on your behind, not leaning on your in the dead. I command that stone to cut fire. Every generational stone, they say she will not make it. They say you can't go. They say you will not succeed. You will be one place every given year. You can't go anywhere. I come as a power in the name of Jesus.
Nothing to show. You are aging, but no results.
You celebrate your birthday with nothing to show. That is the intention of the enemies. Everything about you is moving, but your hands are not counting it. You check the calendar, your age is no longer there. But you look around, you can't find anything to match your age. Something is wrong. May God scatter that thing today. Your amen need to go back to that time yet. Your amen will enter your face. Let your amen kill someone tonight. Let your amen scatter the rock. Let your amen break the stone. Let your amen break the foundation. Let your amen enter your face. Your paternal face. Your maternal face. When you shout that amen, you are free. Then the president taking his pen to sign that this one will never receive provisions. He sealed it. He took his seal, a ring, and used it. Apparently, he sealed it. The final man. And they said that the decree might not be changed. So they have spoken concerning you that this woman, I signed it, I vowed with my blood. Even though she traveled, let her not marry. Even though he's educated, and you don't go to the next level. That by the time you walk around, everything you put your hand to do is not working. Because someone has sealed it up with their blood. Someone somewhere have cried with their blood. They seal it up. Then the decree might not be changed. Someone say, come to change. I command that decree now change immediately. I carry you under the cross of Calvary. The blood of Jesus changed. When he died that day, a new decree was made. When he died on the cross, a new decree was made. But that blood of Calvary changed your entire life. My God, can I talk to somebody on the cross of Calvary? That day the doctor told you to do, the very open into two, give you access to God. In other words, the blood covered your iniquity and give you access to the Father. Something is wrong. after the flocks, they close the way. And the next person will not draw. They close it. The seed. How many persons in your family stand in faith? Who is behind the family sorrow? Who is laughing or breaking people down slowly? Who is that agent within the family that's locking people destiny up but calling to check how you're doing? Who is that person that's responsible for the frustrations and disappointment of people in the family, but yet still you're still feeding the person, still sponsoring them, still assisting them, but they won't seal it up with a seal. Say, this thing should not change. Don't change it. Don't change it. King Darius and Daniel were connected. They were best friends. But what puzzled me most is, why were he sealed up? He would have said, no, this is Daniel. I will change the decree. It will not work. But the king sealed up. Then you went to the tomb. Daniel, the God that you served, let him save you. Daniel, I understand that you serve God, but I don't know your Lord, Daniel. I grew up worshiping God that I can see, even though I'm connected to you, Daniel. But let me see the strength of the God that you serve. That was doubt me in the other way. I know you serve different God, and I serve different God, but we are connected. But I want to see the strength of your God. I will place you behind back for your God to pull himself. And he pushed. Boom. They locked the door. The stone. And Daniel was there. But church, listen to this. My revelation. Before they arrested Daniel, he was already in the spirit. The man was sober in the spirit, not in the flesh. Sober, and arrested him in the realm of the taking. You were not physically strong. After seeking the face of God, fasting everything, they collected him. And then the lion, by revelation, they feast on flesh. So they knew that we're going to throw down in the lion's den. They never gave the lion flesh. They kept them to be hungry because Daniel was coming. The enemy knew that when Daniel entered, it would tear into pieces. So they denied the lion flesh for some days. That Daniel will enter and then the pieces him. And then Daniel too, while there, you were fasting to pray. So he didn't eat any food, no flesh. He killed the flesh. Daniel killed the flesh in him. He was not spiritually strong. So when they took Daniel into the lion's den, the lion couldn't see flesh to eat. The feast on flesh. When he entered into the lion's den, the lion feast on flesh. And Daniel was no longer in the flesh, he was in the spirit. He was fasting before they took him, so he killed the flesh. Any man that walk in the flesh is on the job of God. Those that walk in the flesh is the job of the devil.
Yes. My God.
Who walk after the flesh, who after the spirit.
Yes, sir.
So Daniel was not in the flesh, the lion feast on flesh. So when they threw him into the lion's den, the lion said they couldn't find flesh to eat. He was not spiritually strong. And man was qualified around the spirit. So they looked at him and said, no, this man have no flesh. When you're in the flesh, that's when you fall into trouble. It's in the flesh you fall into all kinds of trouble. The desire of the flesh. Frustrating Christian. So the lion looked at him up and down. No food. What are people disappointed with this? Why would they bring somebody like this? They check, they come back. And they lie down on Daniel. And Daniel sat on them. Now, it came to pass in the Bible, Genesis, God gave Adam dominion over everything.
Yes.
And Adam sat down. He named all the animals in the garden.
Yes.
Adam was given the authority to name the animals, including lion. That name was given to them by men.
Amen.
So when Daniel stepped into the day in the realm of the spirit, he took over the authority, the dominion God gave him in Genesis.
Amen.
I need you. You can't eat me.
Amen. Yes. Yes.
When you stand back and know your place in Christ, the thing that frustrates you. When you know your place, and know your place in Christ, and know who you are in Christ, what frustrates all that can frustrate you, what break people down can break you down, because you are connected to Him that moves everything. So Daniel entered into the lion's den, he went back to the authority that gave you dominion over the fowl of the air, the beast of the field, the fish of the sea, the beast of the field. Hallelujah. I'm reading verse 16, Joshua chapter 10, verse 16. Now the five kings have fled and hidden in the cave at Megiddo. 17. When Joshua was told that the five kings have been found hiding the king, hiding in the cave at Megiddo. Verse 18, the last. He said, roll Lice rock up to the mouth of the cave and pour some men there to guard it. When he found out that the king was in the cave, he told men, roll the stone and close that place. And place people to guide it, they shouldn't come up. Man of God, they will die. Yeah. Yep. Now listen, what I got from that text, one king have thousands of people to feed. Mm-hmm. One king has so many people depend on him. Now you put five kings in a cave, you know how many people are suffering. So when the breadwinner is behind the stone, what happened to others? When the one the family is depending on is not happy, what happened to others? If Joseph was staying in the dungeon during the time of the 7 years of famine, what would have happened to Israel? Five kings were locked up and placed behind the stone. They locked them up. And Joshua said, place people, the guy locked, blocked the door, close the entrance, let them be inside it. Number one, no light. Number two, mosquito become your friend. Number three, they beg for food to eat. People that used to have food enough to eat and to give out. Now they're in a cave. No, now they will beg for water to drink. King, I'm saying king, king. Now begging for food, begging for water. You see the enemy plan? It's to break the breadwinner of the family down and make it a beggar. Yeah. To make that sister or that brother a beggar. The one that's supposed to call the sibling and say, come out, what do you want? What is your project? School fee, this. But that person is begging. The one that's supposed to supply bread to the family, not asking for bread. The one that's supposed to build houses is not squatting. Behind the stone, five kings. Kings, they disrupted. The real God was taken away. And then they were hiding. They left the palace, they were hiding in the cave. They couldn't come out. How would they eat? No food. No water. No light. Inside a dark place. People that were having comfort yesterday. Few hours ago, they were on AC. Few hours ago, they were commanding respect. You come here. Few hours ago, royal gown on them. Few hours ago, followers were behind them. All of a sudden, boom! Their life caught up. They were now in a dark place, surviving, just managing life. Who did this to you? Who did this to you? That every year you're greater. Every year the same level. Every year the same frustration. Every year the same thing. I want to say that as a wrap up quickly. When you can't push your way to the top, you will have no respect. Respect comes with results. If your friends will start respecting you, then the result has to be there. If there's no change, people will not respect you. All the people running away from you because nothing happened. You see why people going away? All your friends, they're leaving you. Nothing to show. Soon you have evidence. Soon you have substance. Soon you have results. All the people, you won't tell them to come back. They will start coming back. They will call you. I just call to check on you how you doing. I dream about you last night. Because of who you are. Man of God, go back to Bible and just a minute to prominent. Reuben, Judah, and the rest. This is our brother. This is our brother. The same people that saw him because of this is our brother. This is our brother. People will only come back to you when you start having it. So what do you do? Make your way in your top down behind the stone while you are there. Push the stone. Push the stone. Don't give up. Stop complaining. Stop murmuring. Push. Begin to ask God for strength. Why inside? Push the stone. Don't stop murmuring there. Don't stop complaining behind. Push the stone.
Yes, sir.
Man, the king, why will you leave your chamber early morning to go to the lion's den? The king said, when he sent someone to go check, he went there.
Daniel, I shall God deliver thee.
He waited. One of the boys see.
Daniel!
And the voice came from inside.
Yes, my Lord. The God that I serve saved me from the lion. He came up with no scratch.
Yes, sir.
Where life is, when you come from behind the line, the experience alone will make another mistake. You come with a broken relationship and enter into the new relationship. The experience will make you fix the one you need now. From the past, you've been right. The past mistake. I can't be the same again as yesterday. I can't do the same thing I used to do. I will not do the same thing. No. When he came, I had no scratch on him. And the king said, Daniel, I've seen your God. Let's test our own God. They gathered the same people together.
My God, my God.
Go back there to let's see. And when your enemies will know that the God you were serving, even though he was quiet, but he was walking. God is a God that walks behind the scene. Man of God will not please you. He will displease you to please you.
Yes.
You are crying, but you don't have time. He said, see what I'm telling you. God will help you. He said, no, it's for your good. I will watch you. I will walk on you just to take you there. You won't like it, but I will do it. You will cry, you won't listen. He's taking you somewhere, and you'll be happy tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
So
So God allowed the people to play right in the Lion's game for his name to be magnified in Babylon.
Yes.
You want to take his glory in Babylon, but there's no avenue to you. So God brought Daniel in the city. I will place you behind the stone and I'll put you out for the people to know me. So God is locking you up in order to expose you.
Yes.
Hey.
So my thing is not working. Let people talk on the talk. You have a personal relationship with God. And you know what you're going through is not for evil. It's to mold you for the next level. So don't think that God is frustrating you because up to this age you are still single. You are single is your training. God is training you. Because when you get to the right person that's supposed to marry you, you already trained. You have been schooled. So you're not broken. Someone left me saying you lost the relationship. No, you just graduated.
Hallelujah.
You just graduated. To them, it's a broken heart. To you, at school.
Yes.
School. From one level to another.
Yes.
At school. You got to pass through. They gave you certificate. So certificate will be TS. Yes!
Yes.
Your own certificate will be different from my own.
Yes.
So congratulations. Amen. You just passed. But you passed with tears in your eyes. The next level.
Amen.
The man was praying to God and threw him behind the stone. Just imagine. He was not praying to the devil.
No.
He was worshiping God 3 times a day. Not even one time. Mm. 3 times a day. Yes, they were collecting him. Placing behind the stone. Why would God do such things? But to expose Daniel to the entire nation. He was worshiping God in corner. Man, God, listen. He was worshiping God in the corner. And God wanted to be known publicly, not in the corner. So God said, I will place you behind the stone to expose you to the public. So when Daniel went in the lion's den, at the end of the day, the whole nation bowed down to the God of Daniel. Read Bible.
Whoa.
He was in the corner, nobody knew his God. So when God took him behind the stone, he came out, the entire nation worshiped the God of Daniel.
Yes, sir.
So what you experience it behind the stone is training.
Ah.
God want to use you to glorify himself. He want to use that situation you're in, that let marriage, that frustration, that barriers, to bring out his glory. Let people talk what they want to talk. Let them discuss how many times your life is bitter. Let them say you lost relationship. That's when it is broken, she frustrated, she bitter. That is the own cup of tea. Your own is that God is training you. Everybody got to go through the training process. My own training is different from your training. Thank God for you to marry. But I'm single now because God is working on me. I am not frustrated. I am not disappointed. I am a child of God. God will have a grandchild. I'm not God's granddaughter. I'm not a grandson. I am connected to him. He is my father. He is not wicked. The Bible says James chapter 1 verse 17. All better and good gift coming from the Father above. He is not the father of evil. So when I'm going through, something good is happening. Even though my eyes cannot see it, I know that God is working for my good. Everything working for the good. People gossiping you everywhere.
Yeah.
This one is for someone. Someone. Somebody here. We are closing. I'm closing my section right now. I'm about to pray for somebody. But listen to this message. Carry it home. For those watching online, God is talking to you somewhere in your house, somewhere in your room, somewhere in your car. You are crying, God, why me? Because of who you are. That's why you're going through what you're going through. Your brother and sister are going through it because they are not the breadwinner. The Lord gave you the bread to carry. That's why God treated you. Because the entire family load is on your head. Everything concerning your family is on your shoulder. The entire Babylon will soon know you. That's why God wants you to go through what you're going through.
Amen.
I close in John chapter 11 right here. Lazarus, I know, I told you last night, you were playing behind the stone. Until Jesus came. Jesus allowed them to play behind the stone before he arrived. But Lazarus stayed there, Jesus never entered. But he allowed it to place him behind the stone before he arrived. Where is God? God, where are you? God, where are you? All these things are happening to me. Look at me. Lord, I came to the nation with zeal. I talk about now, but I've been so much better. Where are you? He can answer the second period of your life. God will not speak. Man of God, the second time in your life when you will call him, you will not answer. Not that he hates you, but the ego got to allow the agent to go down. God is treating you in the way you yourself don't understand. So allow God to walk on you. The tree behind the stone, and Daniel cried. But behind the stone was his victory.
Amen.
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 God bless you. Pastors still go behind the stone.
Yes.
You preach it anointed. You carry the grace to make things happen. You preach that people bless and you're not blessed. Behind the stone ministry. You stand to the minister and the church decrees. The next day you see 100, the next day you see 20 people. God, what is happening? You fast and pray. And the more you fast, the more the people go. The more you are fasting, the more the people are going.
God bless you.
God, what is happening? Then you go back in the closet. You take 7 days dry. You come outside. You enter the Sunday service, nobody. Behind the stone. Behind the stone ministry. When you anointed 24 people enough for yourself.
Yes.
Anointed. A pastor prayed. Rebuked demons. And he said, a child, the demon couldn't go for his son. His first son. The son stubborn.
Yes.
Can stand before the pastor, insulting. People bring their own stubborn children to him. He said, demon, go out and scream and leave. You look at one of these things and say, Papa, move your hand on me. Move your hand on me, Papa. Move your hand. Father will just put your hand on me. But you throw out other people to the God to go. But yet, your own behind the stone. Then you ask God wisdom. God, what is happening to me?
Speak.
In that time, God is changing your anointing. And upgrading your system, you may not understand. What a man trying to defend God in Egypt by killing an Egyptian, and then his own people start running behind. Moses stood and killed an Egyptian. He said, "For them." And the same person look at him, who make you Lord over us? The same people he was fighting for. They turned to him, you, why you killed him? Why you kill this man? The man was trying to kill you. And Moses' sister had disputed him and killed him. And you told to him, who made you Lord over us? Why you kill him? I'm going to tell the people. He ran in the town and told the Egyptian that Moses had killed one of you. Moses, they ran behind him. But listen to the ministry. They were pursuing him. They were taking him to God.
Yes, sir.
The Lord never went up to Moses to where the problem was. In the city, he went into the desert. While they were pursuing him, God was there waiting for him. God will not stop you from entering into the fire, but he will meet you in the fire.
Yes.
Please stand up.
Yes, sir.
Take that. He will not stop you from entering into the fire, but he will meet you in the fire.
Yes.
In the fire, that's where he will meet you. Second mission of Gilead, he never promised it. The students said, if a God will not save us, we'll die. They were standing for him. God now came. So we came back. We're standing for God. We came back. We know our God. God never came down to save them. The heat and the fire, God looked at the people hitting it. He never stopped it. The people that were coming there, the heat killed them. God never stopped it. But when they threw them into the fire, the four men appeared.
Yes, sir.
God will always enter into the problem to stop it.
Uh-huh.
He will not stop you from entering into the problem, but he stops the problem when you're in the problem.
Ah.
Everybody here, I want us to pray. I don't know what you're going through, but there's something you're going through right now that you won't tell the next person by yourself. It's personal. No matter who you friend with, you can never say it all. You only brush up. But the deeper part of it will not expose it. We call it a personal issue. We're going to pray right now. Get this grace to go through it. Behind the stool ministry, it's not easy. Behind the stool life, it's not easy. Many great men died behind the stool because they gave up. They couldn't force their way out. They died behind the stone and nobody knew them. Engineers are lying down in the cemetery there. They couldn't make their way out. Doctors are lying down right here in the cemetery. They couldn't make their way. They died without saving one life. Pastors lying down there died without saving one soul. They gave up along the way. They couldn't make it to the top. Some people that are broken from relationship 1, 2, 3, they take poison. Some commit suicide. They die from broken heart. They couldn't stand to go through. But if God can keep you out of 4 or 5 and you still standing, there's a reason. With all the bitterness, with all the dry season you're experiencing, and you're still smiling, you're still laughing, you're still looking at me, you're still sweet, there's something behind. Keep holding on. Keep holding on. Keep holding on. Keep holding on. We're going to pray now. Everyone that placed me behind the stone, put them to shame.
Yeah.
2 prayer for you, 1. Put them to shame and then give me the grace to come out with the glory.
Yeah.
Darius placed him there. But God took him out.
Yeah.
I'm talking to somebody. Pray. God Almighty. We sustain you. We prove your enemies wrong. You will come out with no scratch.
Amen.
You will come out with smiling.
Amen.
You will come out with laughing. Pray now. Slap and pray for yourself. God is able to take you from behind that stone. If God did it for that. don't know who placed you there, but I know God can take you from there. I don't want to know who placed you there, but I know God is able to deliver you. I don't want to know who kept you there. All that I know that God is able to deliver you from that place. Before December ends, you will be smiling again. Before the year comes to an end, you will be laughing again. Before the year comes to an end, you will be rejoicing again. Receive it right now. I pray for every soul in this building. The person that placed you there will see you coming out. The one that kept you there will be surprised to see the next level. The one that placed you behind the school will be surprised to see your next level. I pray for strength. I pray for strength. And you will not give up behind the school. And you will not die behind the school. And you will not cry behind the school. Mold of your side. Receive strength to survive. Receive grace to keep going. Receive speed to come from behind. The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, he will deliver you from behind that stone. What made you better is coming to an end. What made you frustrated is coming to an end. What kept you single is coming to an end. What kept you behind is coming to an end. The thing that made you better is coming to an end. The thing that hides you from people is coming to an end.
Live video, can please thank you for watching right now. Goodbye.